as much as this proper planning from the ministry's side, they are frustrated by the National Treasury. Either because in the National Treasury, there are gaps that need to be addressed in terms of proper forecasting, in terms of how much revenue they will raise, what kind of projects they will be implemented, or there is just sudden of change of heart in the middle of the budget cycle. And therefore, Mr. Speaker, as much as we want to blame ministries and departments for these pending bills, it may not be their own making. But not to say they have also had roles to play, because in the midst of budget implementation, they realized maybe we would have given B priority and not C. And therefore, they find themselves procuring things that are not within their procurement plan. Mr. Speaker, the issue of pending bills means then that we are flouting our own laws in terms of PFMA and Public Procurement and Disposal Act, whereby you're not supposed to procure what has not been, what is not within the budget. You are not supposed to even think that you can engage in procurement, not unless you're sure that that money is in your coffers. Mr. Speaker, I also want to address the issue of projects that are counterfunded. Some are funded by our coffers, others by external lenders and our partners, World Bank loans from our development partners. And Mr. Speaker, it becomes so very difficult to know which money went where. At times the money is borrowed, projects are not implemented, and of course, by at the point where ink meets the paper and their signatures are to, as to the aspect that monies have been borrowed, they start earning interest. Interest on commitment fees, interest on the principal amount. Mr. Speaker, it's the high time that we started thinking as a country, at what point must we go look for debts? Because like today, we are speaking of so much money that has been borrowed, but has not yet hit our coffers. We are paying commitment fees when this money is still in somebody's coffer or pocket, I mean the lender's pocket. It's just like walking to the bank, borrowing money, but that money does not hit your pocket, but you continue paying commitment fees because you borrowed, and it's the money that you're not spending. And therefore, Mr. Speaker, we need to put the debt management office to on the spot, so that then they should not be borrowing happy to borrow money that you're not spending. Mr. Speaker, allow me to digress a little on issues that have been happening, and of course that raises a lot of questions because we are members' representatives. On the issue of schools, because this is an issue that we need to bring to the fore. Our students are registered in NEMIS. During the disbursements of capitation, you find that a school has like 500 students that are registered in NEMIS, National Education Management Information System. But the monies that hit the school's account is half amount of whatever registration, the number of registered students in that school. Where is the rest of the money going? When the managers of this school ask these questions, they are told that, you know, the only numbers that we have are so much. Where is the rest of the money going? I am asking this because I've had so many head teachers and principals of secondary schools complaining that indeed this is a number that is registered, but we're not getting what is commensurate with our numbers. Mr. Speaker, we need to get to a level, maybe, whereby this school, where our schools will no longer be managed by the school principals and head teachers. Let the National Treasury employ bursars who are paid directly from the National Treasury as competent school managers, so that they can run schools and have a link that is between the National Treasury, the Ministry of Education, and the school bursars that are answerable directly to the National Treasury, who is the holder of the pass of this country. Mr. Speaker, on the issue of quota awards, why is it that we have so many litigations in as far as contracts are concerned? And every time there are these litigations, the government is losing. And the whooping kind of awards that are awarded to the so-called litigants Allowance share goes to the lawyers, advocates who are acting on behalf